You're probably asking yourselves, if the event-driven model has just one thread, then how do we achieve concurrency? In the multi-process and the multi-threaded models, we had each execution context, whether it's a process or a thread, handle only one request at a time. To achieve concurrency, we would simply add multiple execution contexts, so multiple processes or multiple threads. And then if necessary, if we have fewer CPUs than contexts, then we would have to context switch among them. The way the event-driven model achieves concurrency is by interleaving the processing of multiple requests within a same execution context. Here in the event-driven model, we have a single thread, and the single thread switches its execution among the processing that's required for different requests. Let's say we have a client request coming into the system, so it's a request for client C1, and we receive a request for a connection that gets dispatched, the accept operation gets processed. Then we receive the actual request, so the HTTP message, that gets processed, the message gets parsed, we extract the files. So now we actually need to read the file and we initiate IO from the reading file handler. So at that point, the request for client one has been processed through several of these steps and it's waiting on the disk IO to complete. Let's say in the meantime, two more requests have come in. So client two and client three have sent a request for a connection. Let's say the client two request was picked up first, the connection was accepted, and now for the processing of client two, we need to wait for the actual HTTP message to be received. So the processing of client two is waiting on an event from the network that will have the HTTP message that needs to be received. And let's say client three, its request has been accepted and it's currently being handled. So the client three request is in the accept connection handler. Some amount of time later, the processing of all of these three requests has moved a little bit further along. So the request for C3, the accept connection was completed, and now that request is waiting on an event with the HTTP message. The request for client 2, that one perhaps we're waiting on the disk IO in order to read the file that needs to be sent out, and maybe the request for client C1 already started sending the file in chunks at a time, so blocks of some number of bytes at a time, so it's waiting in one of those iterations. So although we have only one execution context, only one thread, if we take a look, we have concurrent execution of multiple client requests. It just happens to be interleaved, given that there is one execution context. However, there are multiple at the same time, multiple client requests being handled.